10, when Jesus came up out of the water, Mark writes, immediately he saw the heavens open, the Spirit descending upon him like a dove. We get no extra or background details from Mark. No mention of Jesus ever thinking about or preparing for baptism. No mention of plans he had to visit his cousin John. Just 7 days, remember 7 days ago, Jesus was 12 years old. And you will recall the surprise in verse 50 of Luke chapter 2 when Mary and Joseph found Jesus in the temple. They did not understand what Jesus meant when he said, I must be in my Father's house. They didn't get it. Today, 7 days later, Jesus is 30 years old. And there he is in the Jordan River to be baptized by John. Do we get it? Did John get it? New students were being given a tour of a large university campus, stopping in front of the administration building and pointing out to the window in the president's office. The tour host said, the president is a very down-to-earth people person. There's hardly a day that you won't see him in the cafeteria mingling with students. He is a real joiner. Today you hear the most profound, I'm here for you, I join you in all of your days, in your living, in all of your dying. It's what Jesus' baptism declares and what Mark urgently wants us to know. How odd of God, you say. Jesus a candidate for baptism? Do Christians get it? Why is Jesus, sinless, spotless Lamb of God, getting baptized? Why does the baptism of repentance for the forgiveness of sins, what does that have anything to do? What does it mean to Jesus? John had a hard time understanding. John had called the whole nation to repentance. Had he not just said, one who is mightier than I is coming after me, I am not worthy to bend down and unstrap his sandals? You and I, yes, it's a different story. Sinners need baptism. Only by baptism do we stand clean, pure, sinless, forgiven, recreated, reborn, alive before the Father. But that doesn't exactly answer why this Sunday turns our eyes to him in the Jordan. The key to the answer is that he has come to make his blessings. He has come to live in our place, to stand in the place of sinners. He has come to demonstrate, I'm here for you. As much as our sins are washed away and regeneration is ours in holy baptism, what Jesus receives is quite the opposite. He takes on our sins, the sins he ultimately takes to the cross. His baptism, not just the beginning of his ministry, filled with teaching and miracles, but is his first step toward Calvary. the Holy Cross upon your heart, that you would always love and fear him who has joined you. Receive the sign of the cross upon your hands, that you would readily serve him who has joined you. Receive the sign of the Holy Cross upon your feet, so that you would ever walk in the way of him who has joined you. Receive the sign of the Holy Cross upon your eyes, so that you will ever look to him who has joined you. Receive the sign of the Holy Cross upon your ears, so that you would always listen the word of him who has joined you. Now the Lord of the Jordan does not occasionally or casually mingle among us for a time, but he sticks with us through all time and ages, sinless yet taking on our skin. More and more we see his grace upon grace and the love of God for sinners. In baptism, hear it again. Heaven is, Mark's word, immediately torn open for us. And the kind voice of the Father declares, "You, my son, you, my daughter, you, my child, are beloved, and with you I am well pleased." How dreadful it would be for him to join us, give us so much and open heaven for us, and we did not realize it or recognize it. It would be like sitting in a dark, cold prison eating breadcrumbs while the chains that have bound us have been loosened and the door to the cell is wide open. Our Lord is baptized to set prisoners free, to open our eyes to the joy of a new day. It was a new day when you and I were washed with water and the word. Should you forget the date, lose the certificate, or the baptismal dress worn that day has crumbled with time, you have lost little. You can never know he has joined you in the Jordan and has made you well-pleasing in the Father's eyes. A young lady, unsure of her spiritual welfare, went to talk to her pastor about her uneasiness. "Pastor, what must I do? What must I do to get right with God?" The pastor answered very calmly, "I'm sorry, you're too late." The woman was even more downcast. But after a moment of silence, the pastor continued, "No, you're not too late to be saved, but you're too late to do anything. Jesus has done everything that needed to be done. Jesus has done everything needed to be done when he went under the water in the Jordan. Jesus has done everything to be done when we were drowned in the waters of baptism and when we arose to new life in Christ. Jesus came to this world to take the only thing that you had to give him, your sin, capital S, capital I, capital N. And though it was a filthy exchange, he took it gladly. In exchange, he's given you everything that is his. In fact, you trade places with the Son of God. Your sin becomes his, and his righteousness